The next morning, Francine offered Arthur a cookie. "Yuck," said Arthur. "This tastes like soup and toothpaste." April Fool laughed at Francine, but Arthur was too worried to laugh. "I'll never remember my magic tricks for the assembly," he said. "Climb down," said Buster. "I'll be your assistant. I'll help if you get stuck." Arthur felt better. He could count on Buster. But just before the assembly, Buster got caught putting sneezing powder on Mr. Rabban's desk. Instead of going to the assembly, Buster went to the principal's office. "I'll blow it for sure without Buster," thought Arthur. He walked into the auditorium, who was sitting in the front row, Binky Burns. This was going to be even worse than he thought. Arthur worried while Mr. Rabban read people's minds. He worried while Francine and Murphy did shadow tricks. And he worried while the chorus sang "That Old Black Magic." Finally, it was his turn. "For my first trick," said Arthur, "I'll need a volunteer." Binky Burns jumped on the stage. "Surprise, Pipsqueak," he whispered. Arthur gulped.